Stanbridge's senior and sophomore English classes have begun this year by reading Shakespeare's Hamlet. This was not only to appreciate Shakespeare's work, but to appreciate some very dedicated actors from San Francisco Shakespeare Festival.
Though yet of Hamlet, our dear brother's death, the memory be green, and that it us befitted to bear our hearts in grief.
What's the matter, my lord? Between who? I mean the matter you do read, my lord.
To sleep. Perchance to dream. I must be cruel, only to be kind.
The king's jester.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him.
The king! The king's to blame!
The group was kind enough to perform Hamlet for Stanbridge in A2, and even led them in some theater exercises afterward. This is the third year in a row they've come to Stanbridge to give students a chance to see that year's play performed.
Got to interact with the actors. It was fun. I haven't done acting before, so it's my first time.
I was either Rosencrantz or Guildenstern, one of those characters. And I got to go on stage and even backstage. And I even had a line, yes. So it was really fun and really awesome.
My favorite part is the duel.
My favorite part of the play was I liked that when they were fighting and they killed each other and they lie down on the ground.
My favorite part was the ending of the play.
My favorite part was the fake fencing match.
Thank you again, San Francisco Shakespeare Festival, and I'll see you next time on Stanbridge Student News.
I first met Lauri Kober when I was interviewed by her on behalf of student government. At the time, she was working on a free evaluation of Stanbridge Academy on behalf of the Harvard Business School. This time, I got to learn a little bit more about her during a brief interview we had. What do you do at Stanbridge?
My name's Lauri Kober, and I am the business officer and CFO for Stanbridge.
What's your favorite part about Stanbridge?
I think my favorite part would be the people, both the students and the faculty and staff. Everyone here is wonderful, and I have to say this is one of the first jobs where I really enjoy coming to work every day.
Is there a cool fact that you want students to know about you?
Let's see. I have two sons, they're both in college, two dogs, and I love snakes.
Oh, really?
Yes. I think if you go on the website, there's a picture of me with a giant python.
Wow! That is a pretty cool fact. Welcome to Stanbridge, Lauri.
At Stanbridge, more Apple computers are replaced by Chromebooks because they are affordable, lighter, and even have touchscreens. Chromebooks can be easily shared. Each student can make an account on any computer. Teachers and students can work on the same document at the same time.
In class, students use Chromebooks to basically do everything. Homework's on Chromebooks, essays are done on Chromebooks, classwork's done on Chromebooks. It's really great because students can log into their Google account, access documents that I share with them immediately. They can type and I can see exactly what they're typing as they're typing it. So it's a really great way for me to check in and make sure that they're, one, understanding what's going on in the class, and if they've done their homework, if they need help in an essay. I also don't need to hover around them as much. I can kind of be at my desk looking at their essay. They have it open on their desk as well, and so it's a really great tool for collaboration.
Chromebooks were first introduced to Stanbridge by John Barnett.
Yeah, I love Chromebooks. I think that they're super cheap, and they do 90% of what most students need them to be doing. They access the internet, they can use Google Drive, which we use in high school all the time. They can go onto YouTube if we want to look at videos or do things like that. And if they break, they're cheap, so we can buy another one much easier than if we were buying a $2,000 MacBook.
In computer science with Jay, the whole class worked on coding for a tic-tac-toe game.
I use Chromebooks primarily in my computer science class. We started learning things like referencing and data types using Google Sheets as kind of a starting point, and that's where Chromebooks really shined. They access Google Docs very quickly, and the students already knew how to use them.
hope you are enjoying this new technology at school.
Hi everybody, I'm Callie, and it's time for a super duper important public service announcement. From November 16th to December 16th, Stambridge will be collecting donations of canned food to give to the hungry. To donate, please bring any unexpired canned goods to Stambridge and place them in the bin beside the stairs. Please donate and help everybody get a great Thanksgiving dinner. Thanks for watching, guys. Smell you later.
On October 29th, Middle Elementary went to Arata Farm and student broadcasting has the first scoop.
We chose to take the kids to this farm because last year we went to Lemos Farm and it was really fun, but we wanted to take them somewhere new and this had a lot of activities for them to do.
I think they enjoyed the maze the most, but they also rode the ponies, they rode the hay wagon behind a chugging tractor. They bounced for almost an hour in the playground, you know, a couple of bouncy houses, and I was really amazed at their camaraderie when they were playing on the playground. It was heartening to see that.
At Awada's farm, there was a lot of things to do. We only had to do one at a time, so our first was the maze. But not any old maze, a maze that's just a hay bale maze. Imagine that, just a hay bale maze, and you have to find your way out. It was pretty hard, we even lost someone.
What I liked about the farm was the hay maze. We got in it twice.
I liked doing the hay maze the first time.
I found the actual exit.
I liked about the farm was the haunted house, because it was a mix of scary and creepy.
My favorite part, I think, was the hayride.
The trip sounded awesome. See you next time on Stambridge Student News.